I'm Arpa Flack and welcome to Fried and Tasted. All the recipes here are tried and tested. So by now you must know that I'm a big fan of mousse cakes. So here I have a very beautiful and elegant orange mousse cake. You can see that I just want you to take a moment and look at the layers. For it, the first layer is the sponge cake and then I have orange jello, along with orange mousse and some more orange jello, which is topped with some orange rings. So this cake is really very easy to make. I mean, I know the first impression you get is that it must be so complicated, but trust me, it is not at all. And it is so good to prepare a night before. I mean, if you have some guests coming at home, you can easily prepare it a night before and just leave it and take it out only when you have to serve it. So let's see how to make it. So I'll roughly go through the ingredients now. The exact measurements are in the description below. This time I've also put the measurements in like grams as well as cup. So whatever you have, you can use it, like whatever measuring instrument you have, you can have an exact measurement of the ingredients either way. So here I have taken a sponge cake. It's a regular sponge cake. You can see a basic sponge cake recipe on my profile itself. I will put the link also in the description below. You can make another kind of sponge cake, or you can also use simply digestive biscuits, like you just crumb it and use it as a base. Here I am using this sponge cake. Now here are the ingredients for the mousse and the jello layer. So I have taken some orange juice. It's freshly squeezed orange juice. And here I have some sugar. First I'm going to cook these two and make an orange juice concentrate from it. I'll use this concentrate in preparing the rest of the mousse and jello. Okay, so here I have some gelatin. I'll be using, like I'll divide it and use it in the preparation. Then here I have some yogurt, cream cheese, whipped cream, whipping cream, we have to whip it. Then some vanilla essence and then some more sugar. So you can see I have some sugar here and some sugar here and little bit of warm water. That is all we need for this orange mousse cake. I also want you to see the setup that I've prepared here. So I have two cake pans. Let's see the first one. The first one is the 6-inch cake pan. It's the same pan in which I prepared this sponge cake. And now I have taken it out and lined it with a cling foil. The reason to line it with a cling foil is that whatever I put inside, I can easily remove it and nothing sticks on the side. So this is the first pan. The second pan is slightly bigger than the first pan. So the first pan is 6 inch or 15 centimeter. So this one is like around 7 inches, which is like around 18 centimeter or a little bigger than 18 centimeter. Somewhere around that. So what I did for this, it's just, what I have is just a cake ring. If you have a spring foam pan, well and good. I don't have it, so I've used a cake ring and I have put a base here. What I did that I put a cling wrap around it so that when I pour mousse, the mousse does not flow out, and I have stuck it with some cello tape around it. So this way it is very tight and it's firm from the bottom, and this is to give some more support at the base. What else I did that I took an acetate paper like this and I have put it around it. This is completely optional, but I did it just to give a cleaner finish to the cake. Our first step is to make an orange juice concentrate, which I'll be using throughout this recipe in batches. So for that, here I've taken some fresh orange juice and sugar and I'm gonna cook it until it just comes to a boil. In the meanwhile, here I'm blooming some gelatin with water. So in total for the recipe, I'll be taking 20 grams of gelatin, but here I'm just blooming 10 grams of that with a little bit water and just keep it aside to bloom. And here the orange juice has come to a boil, so I'll take it off the flame. The orange juice concentrate has come to a room temperature and I have transferred it into a measuring jar like this, which has the mls written on it. This makes my job very easy. So first I'm going to take around 80 ml of the total 300 ml of orange juice. Of course, you can find all the details in the description below. So right now we can just concentrate on the steps. So you can see that here is my 6-inch cake pan, which I have lined with cling wrap,
and I have placed my sponge cake inside it, and now I'm soaking it with the orange juice concentrate that we took out. I have also made some holes inside the sponge cake just so that it absorbs the orange juice better. And once it is done, I'll just take it off the pan and then just simply wrap it with the cling wrap and keep it aside for it to soak it nicely. Our next step is to make the orange jello layer, which is the second layer. For that, I'm going to line this pan again with this cling wrap. And you remember the 10 grams gelatin that we bloomed in the beginning. For that, I'm going to take now half of that bloomed gelatin. The remaining half of the bloomed gelatin I will use at the for the topmost jello layer. So here is that bloomed gelatin. I'll simply melt it and take some more of the orange juice, around 120 ml of the orange juice here, and then add the melted gelatin in it, mix it nicely, and here our thick orange jello layer is almost in the making. I'll just transfer it into the pan and then put it in the freezer for 1 hour. I want you to know that I'm going to put it in freezer for 1 hour just so that it sets nicely and quickly. And now I'm taking another 10 grams of gelatin. Let me show you that the bloomed gelatin that we saved in the previous layer is still there. And like I said, I'll use it for the topmost jello layer. But here for the orange mousse layer, I'm soaking some gelatin with water again and keep it aside to bloom for around 10 minutes. In the meanwhile, I'll prepare some mousse whipping cream. So for that here, I have taken some chilled whipping cream and then I'm just going to whip it until it becomes a little thick. And when it reaches that consistency, I'll simply add some cream cheese in it, along with some yogurt, and then whisk it again just to combine everything. This will not take more than a minute or so. And once all of it is well combined, I'll simply add some sugar in it, along with vanilla essence. And then once again, the orange juice concentrate that we prepared in the first step is going to come in action. So here I'll use the 75 ml of the orange juice concentrate and then whisk everything to combine. And I have also melted the bloomed gelatin and then add it into the mousse, and then just with the help of my spatula combine everything so that the gelatin is well mixed into the batter. So now our mousse batter is ready as well. Now let's look at the orange jello layer that we prepared just before this step. You can see that it is not too stiff because we didn't keep it in freezer for long, and it is just set like the way we wanted it to be. On the other side here, my sponge cake has soaked the orange juice pretty nicely, and very carefully now I'll just lift up this orange jello layer and place it on the sponge cake and then remove the cling wrap carefully. You can see that both of them are of the same size. And now I lift up the sponge cake and place it carefully inside this 7-inch cake ring. If you have a spring foam pan, you can do it more easily, and I'll place it in such a way that there is still a little bit of space around it for the mousse to flow in. And this is how it looks like from top. And now I'll just pour this orange mousse layer over the top just so that everything is full, with a little bit of space on top for the orange jello layer at the end. And then again I'll just freeze it for 1 hour. Now just 15 minutes before taking out the orange mousse from the freezer, here is the bloomed gelatin that we saved in the jello layer that I prepared in the first step. So I have melted it in microwave for 30 seconds, and here is the remaining orange juice. I'll just add some water in it to make it a little more transparent, and then I'll simply add this melted gelatin into it and combine everything. And once this is done, I have also cut the orange rings like this, and I have taken the mousse out of the freezer. It is set enough so if I place the orange rings on it, the rings won't sink down, So I'll just carefully place this orange ring on the sides. You can just put it in any way you want. So here goes the last piece in the center, and then I'll carefully pour the orange jello. This one is a little transparent, like I said before. So I'll just pour it on top of these rings, and if any one of them starts slipping off, I'll just simply use my spoon to set it. You can see that it has started to look beautiful now itself. Here comes the time of patience. This orange mousse goes into the refrigerator this time for 4 to 6 hours or overnight. It's the next day now, and I can't wait to see how nicely it has set. So this is my favorite part in the whole process of making any kind of mousse cake, because it's always a surprise to see, you know, how it has turned out. Anyway, so you can see that I've transferred my cake ring onto another cake pan, which is slightly smaller, and then I've simply removed all the tape which was there, and I'll simply slide down the cake ring this way. The cake is completely out of the cake ring, and then I'll just transfer it to the cake board. Be very careful in the whole process, and just remove the bottom cling film which was there, and then also remove the acetate paper which we put around. But just look, because of the acetate paper, the borders have become so smooth and nice. Now let me cut it and show you how it looks like from inside. So you see all the four layers, and you see how gorgeous it looks like, and trust me, it tastes even better. So now you have watched the whole video. Tell me honestly, do you think it was too difficult to make? Of course, it had some measurements and some specifications, but it wasn't so complicated. So make sure you like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, and comment below if you find this cake beautiful.
Of course, if you like this video, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, and help me grow, and look for more videos here. Have a nice day.